Hey guys, Chris with Retro Crypt. I'm gonna play some Bloodstained 2. I haven't been on my PS4 in a while, so it just did a super long upgrade. And I know the sound is a little bit different on the PS4 when streaming through OBS. So I'm doing this without a sound check. Hopefully the sound on the PS4 isn't too overpowering. Sometimes it drowns out my mic, so just keep my mic nice and close to me just in case. Zengetsu, Peerless Swordsman. Dominique. Definitely like Miriam more than Dominique, but Dominique is still pretty good. Definitely playing off of the dynamic between Trevor Belmont and Cypher Belnades, which I like a lot because Castlevania 3 is my favorite Castlevania game. The music kicks ass in these games. I guess people that the developers from that developed DuckTales worked on the soundtrack, and you could tell it's really apparent. Like, growing up, my favorite developers were Capcom and Konami, so this game is a perfect blend of the two. So for Konami, of course, you have Castlevania, you have Metal Gear, there's a lot of shit. Capcom, there's DuckTales, like I said, Mega Man, what else? Street Fighter. There's just way too many classics. Many influential games between those two to even begin to think of choosing who's superior. Both are awesome. Zengetsu hasn't gotten any of his power-ups just yet. Still can't figure out if I like or don't like tutorials in the level. I suppose it's not a bad thing, but, you know, and I try not to be one of those douchey gatekeepers, like, well, we didn't have that back in the day, you had to read the manual, it wasn't in the game. If you didn't have the manual, then you just had to rough it. I feel that way, but at the same time, you know, other people didn't have that, so having tips and tutorials during the, you know, intro level isn't a bad thing at all. I should have thrown the holy water. Not really holy water per se, I don't know, maybe it's like a, kind of like a Molotov cocktail of sorts. Take one more hit. See, the game that I was playing before Malak. It's one of those games that goes for this. But I just think that NC Creates and the team involved with making this game were a lot more experienced. You know, and no shade thrown to the whoever created Malak, but they just didn't have the skill or the resources to put together a game like Bloodstained. You know, not even really comparing the two is just pointless and weird anyway, but it's not like they were striving to be this game, but I'm just comparing the two because that was the last game that I played before this. Like, the gameplay and fluidity is just, like night and day between the two. It feels like they tested this game a lot. You know, they knew what their audience was looking for. I'm talking about Bloodstained, so I'm still gonna give that game, you know, another chance. I got stuck on level 3 just because the, you know, and again, not the shit on it, but just the controls and the gameplays were jank. So, and I hate doing that, like, oh, partly is that I'll readily admit that I'm not some game aficionado. Like, I love to play video games, but I'm not quote-unquote good. But some of it definitely can be attributed to shit controls. Not really shit controls, but just not good controls. This has great controls. Even there's even some instances where, you know, like earlier when I died, I did press jump, but he just didn't jump. I guess sometimes if you're not precise enough, you know, you get a quote unquote unfair death. But, you know, it's really up to you to apply the proper amount of pressure on the button and press it at the right time. I think it's the first stage boss. I don't even remember what it is. Yeah, it's this big dragon. Cool as hell. That was gonna fall. That would have been cool. See, it's been long enough that I played this game where I remember enough, but I've also forgotten enough to where it feels new again. So that was level one.